All right, Tito. Are you missing Friday Night Fights? We definitely missed you. So, welcome to Friday Night Fights. Or Friday Night Fight in this case, because I forgot the S on the Friday Night Fights title. But anyway, so, we're here. Chewy might be joining us, but because they're in Europe, there's a little bit of a time change, so you might hear their voice when they pop online eventually. If not, it would be just be me, and I'm the idea is to pop into the channels to listen to the players navigate against each other. So the two teams that are in the battle tonight for Friday Night Fights are the L Gang, which has the players of Lemur, Lowbrow, Low Ladder, and Gimme Lamp, going against Great Big Three. So some close friends of mine that live local to Nova Scotia is Yachtster and his brother Wingor, and then Corrodin. So piloting for the L Gang is going to be Lemur, while Yachtster will be piloting for the Great Big Three. So let's just do the deck lists real quick. I have a little bit of the VS stats and some of the HSR stats for some of the brings. The L Gang is on the left-hand side for those that are curious about how that's going. And at the top will be the Great Big Three. As you can see by the graphic that's online right now, we have the L Gang's DK is banned. It was an unholy DK. The L Gang brought Outcast, DH, Undead Priest, and Miracle Road. Really no crazy changes with regards to some of the cards. So, and then the Great Big Three had their spell DH banned by the L Gang. They brought an XL Blood DK, Undead Priest, and also a Miracle Rogue. So tonight is going to be the battle of DH versus DK, and then no major differences between the Undead Priests. So, yeah, so should be exciting. The Great Big Three have a little bit more compact list than the L Gang, but for Priest, I should say. So we should see how that goes. I don't think anything else. According to the VS graphic, it looks like the L Gang has got a little bit less favorable matchups there, with the Death Knight being a little bit of a headache. And as well as the priest. So, but we'll see. They got to play the cards. They got to draw the cards. So we get to see what happens. So piloting, as I mentioned earlier, just jumping back to the normal screen, piloting for the Great Big Three is going to be Yachtster. So we're going to be spectating them first. So that to be at the bottom of the screen. And we're going to have Lemur at the top of your screen representing the L Gang. Just going to let the players see if they're ready to go. Oh, they're preparing to battle a friend, so give me a moment here while I am conversing with the individuals. Oh, I could type better. So hopefully everybody's Friday night is going well. Thankfully, summertime is slowly rolling in our neck of the woods. So. Ready to go. Not sure what they're going to bring first, but if I were to guess in this conquest type format, I'm going to say maybe Priest may be starting maybe for both teams, but we'll see. So. So both teams are ready to go. All right, so I let the players know that they can start. Just seeing what is going to be going on here. So again, we're going to be the Great Big Three. Yachtster is going to be the first to spectate, so at the bottom of your screen with Lemur at the tops. Now I'm just waiting for eyeballs, and we will see how things go. Take another quick look at some of the bands again. So it's, it's L Gang's DH, Priest, and Rogue up against DK, Priest, and Rogue of the Great Big Three. So eyeballs are on, spectating, so let's get into the match. So we're going to be listening in on the Great Big Three's first. Okay, so we got the Great Big Three bringing Death Knight going up against Rogue. So, yeah, how that goes. So we'll jump into the Great Big Three's channel and start listening away.
All right.
Well, that's good.
Yeah. It's... We take it. I think Dirty Rat's good in this matchup.
I mean,
it's like Krabatoa's bad, but
Krabatoa, it's fine if we like pull, but they can just step whatever we take, right?
It's one less thing to deal with, I guess. I
suppose.
I see. Guess. Still, man, that's so.
Okay, well.
Mm-hmm.
Always fun.
I mean, nothing, right? No point.
No, there's no point.
Coining. Gets you into. I don't even know what the best secret is here.
Probably. I mean, nothing's really super great.
Feels so odd that there's no Paladin secrets.
Yeah.
Oh, it is sketchy, right?
Yeah, they've got a handful of concoctions. Like they've got two concoctions in hand.
Monster, I guess, I think.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I guess Visage is interesting if we can solo like a big minion, but I don't think we ever have a chance to solo a big minion before. And like might test it, easily get rid of it. Wandering Swain.
Like, it's this is like a potentially okay Dirty Rat turn.
Yeah, like
it's really just Krabatoa.
That's not so bad. Krabatoa would make me super sad, but we could just like coin Blood Boil.
Yeah.
But like, we don't have any AO.
That's good, right?
Yeah. Unless it's like Dirty Rat Blood Body Bagger, but like, what are we doing? Because we can coin the Banshee next turn.
That's interesting. They do have a random.
Yeah, they still have one more concoction, but it's not a full concoction.
Oink.
Oink.
Oh, you can't hear. Oh, shoot. I'll fix that in a second.
I can hear everything.
Everyone can. I like Reaper.
Reaper's just fine. Yeah.
Yeah.
And just hit the.
Yeah. No. No need to make it overcomplicated, I guess.
No.
Well, they run it too, at least. We could just play one and play body bagger.
Yeah.
And turn.
Yeah, there's no need to do anything else.
Yeah, fine by me. Like coin Krabatoa? No.
Okay. Well,
it's only
a slow start for them as well. The longer the game goes, the better for us.
Yeah. Like, we just audio bot, we're fine with that.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Goodbye, I guess.
They haven't really discovered anything, right?
No, they've played all their concoctions.
Yeah, and nothing was like a... And that was just a regular one, too, eh?
Yeah. What?
Is it gonna be here? Oh, okay. Well, we could just deal with that.
Yeah.
Can we deal with it? We can just deal with it with Alistar too, or just trade, and you're gonna give them another bot though.
Really we could care. Also like, is it too fancy if we just like blood boil and trade the 3/3 into the 5/5?
That was my immediate thought, and my next thought was just like, Alistar, do something that way. I think it's fine, right?
Blood boil? Or
Yeah,
I like it.
I don't hate it. It's gonna give us
And trade here and then hit base with the other one?
Yeah. And we hold the weapon one more time.
Yep. We can like play the bot next turn or just deal with a 3/3.
Yeah, I mean we can just hit the 3/3, right? Like if they want to kill off his 5/2. Weapon for it. That's
fine.
That was.
I think we're. Can we just death strike Krabatoa?
Yeah, and then we just. How big is the lifesteal minion?
Be 6/6 after,
and then a 7/7 if we hold the swing.
Yeah,
because that 5/5 is just gonna die.
But so we're always doing this, right?
Yeah. We could also just hero power, right? Or just play Alistar to get the 5-drop in hand.
Or coin audio bot. Just it saves us 3 health like more.
Sure. Yeah, it's a big tempo swing.
We could,
I
and then if we
save coin for soul, but we'll be fine.
That's fair. And do you think we trade here? Get a 7/7?
We trade now. 7/7 is really good. They have to deal with it. They don't think they have any concoctions left, right? So
no.
And they can't. Like, this is a big turn for their graveyard to pop back up to. The only thing to hold the 3/3 was maybe. Well, it was dying anyway. Was, Bone Spike.
True.
But, I mean, if they go in here...
We can discover something with the...
Yeah, I mean, if they don't kill the 7/7, we just straight trade.
Yeah, that too. And we can always clear everything else off and... That's annoying, but...
Yeah, that is...
Yeah, you're right.
This is, Did they get to the lead? Oh, no, okay. They have to kill this straight up.
Is that 3 of them?
This is why I wanted to hold the coin. Because Soul Stealer's a turn away, and this is about to be fucking massive.
Seems true. That's annoying.
How big is this? Like 11-11?
Oh,
yeah, okay. Yeah,
we can hit something off of this.
We gotta hit a 68, like, immediately.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Not quite.
No, we gotta look for something. The more you struggle, the better. That's all bad. That's all so bad.
Sunwell for something?
Sunwell's, I guess it's cheap enough. It's pretty much free, right?
Yeah.
Two, and then it costs one.
I'd say we go for it.
Alright. I just, yeah.
Yeah, you are right, though. I hadn't.
Oh,
man.
Did it rip it? Like. Do we rip it? Like, do we, like, you know what? Because we're gonna Soul Stealer next turn. I mean, we're not.
Yeah.
By any means. RNG.
Come on.
Always. Let's go.
That was illegal.
Get out of here, Sacko, with your nonsense. Believe in the Timbits.
Oh, we knew.
That's, yeah, always. You always take that roll. Now if they go wide, we have the 8 drop.
Yeah. They're probably just going to ask Tor here.
More than likely.
But I feel like it's still fine to drop it, because we can... Breakdance is pretty good, too.
Oh, yeah, that's fair. We can just pick it back up. Do it all again. We could also dirty rat the Absolure out of their hand.
Yeah, that also seems like a good option.
I don't know what is in their hand.
They got an 8 drop Absolure.
They've got one more turn to Absolure. Oh, I mean, they've got a handful of Absolure, so it doesn't really matter what we do, right? Because they picked it up five times.
Yeah.
I'm okay with the bone guy here.
With Soul Stealer?
I think so. Or is there a way we can do this better? I don't think there's a way to do it nicer.
No, I don't think so either.
Unless we trade... There's no... Actually, if we just Hero Power, we could Corpse Explosion. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but that gives them a lot of concoctions.
Yeah, I feel like I like the Soul Stealer.
Yeah. I just... Always keeping that in the back of my head.
I'm hopeful that this will get this off.
I mean, they went in on a lot of stuff there, right? So
yeah, they just have a bunch of Absolures and a bunch of concoctions.
Yeah, we're just gonna have to start. Like,
we really want to hit.
Was nuts, but the Scourge would have been good.
We really want to hit our blood soon to like get some stats on the board.
Yeah, that's gonna be super key.
I mean, these are all decent spells too.
They're not awful. I mean, that one of them's over the top, right? Like we actually can point it at the face.
Yes. Yeah.
So,
can we play two of these?
I mean,
I swear they just
created a different one. I really did not pay attention. Bye, Wengor.
Until another day.
I mean, I'm okay with this turn so far, to be completely honest.
Yeah, it's one Astalor.
Yeah, okay. Do we just play both of our Astalors?
Yeah.
Or do we have to kill this? Oh, that's... Well, that's a good one for when we have to kill an 8-8.
Mm-hmm. We want a dirty rat? Try and dirty rat one right now?
Well, I'm just trying... Well, not really.
No,
I was just thinking to pick up the... we want to pick up the 5-5, right?
We want to pick up this 5-5 or the Astalor 5-5?
I want to pick up... Well, that one clears the board, right?
And if they I'm just thinking with Asphyxiate and Corpse Explosion.
Okay,
yeah.
All right. Let's do that then. And then we'll just trade.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm into it.
Or we could just Do this in Heartstrike.
Oh yeah, do that. It's way better. Yeah, I would rather keep my board. Yeah.
Save the breakdance. We got.
We can breakdance the just the regular Astler, right? Or do I think we need armor? I think we need armor.
Yeah, do this one.
Yeah, I think we need the armor.
Yeah, this is good. Stats on board.
We have another clear. Like we've got asphyxiate. Like this is 12. If they want to just drop the Astler, it's probably not that good for them.
No, it might not even kill everything.
Exactly.
Sometimes feel like going three Astalors isn't. I mean, I don't know if they're. Once you reach that point, I feel like you've almost lost as Rogue.
Well, yeah, it's because now we know like what their game plan is. How many cards they have left? And yeah, I mean, it's still a game, right?
Yeah. Spending your turn to deal 14 damage isn't that good.
And it's not even 14 to our face, right? They're gonna create the first. Okay. Interesting. So they're just gonna go for a colossal. Don't be like. Actually, I don't mind Glug. That brutal dude. Just we got rolled like this last time. This is awful. Do we have the corpse explosion this? Can we even corpse explosion this? Leaves up a... Can we trade corpse explosion? And then we can play... I mean, so we want Vampiric with the Banshee girl, right?
I think... Yeah, I feel like we don't need to worry about corpses. Like, I think we're set up for those.
Oh, I'm not worried about losing corpses. I'm just thinking about what we're going to do with the rest of our stuff.
Just like face, corpse explosion, Astler.
That doesn't clear, though.
No, that does. We have 13 corpses.
Okay.
Yeah. Face.
Maybe I'm thinking corpse explosion. Does it not work like Defile?
No.
Oh, alright. Just... Then don't listen to me. Don't ever listen to me when it comes to corpse explosion. Yeah, okay, that was way better. Never mind. I don't want to listen to it.
We're good.
Why did they think that worked like Defile? This shows how much I played corpse explosion and blood DH. So they're probably gonna
just drop an asteroid, I dare you.
No.
That's fine. Just Astler. Come on, you want to do 12 damage to the face.
They can't, or they can, I guess, yeah. Not an Astler. Oh, they got two shooty Astlers in their hand?
Yeah, and one
maybe
armor.
Armor guy?
Yeah.
Okay.
And one mystery card.
And one question mark.
Better not be a Svalna or whatever.
Oh, wait, we got... Oh, what the hell? The cast of spell would be a one. Okay, fair.
Yeah, this is pretty clean. I say we just Banshee, Blood, Fixiate.
Yeah, I'm into that 100%. Yeah.
See what we get first, but yeah, that doesn't change.
Doesn't change it, but it's a nice draw for sure.
Yeah.
Beauty. All
right. We can just go like Glacial, Wandering.
We can deal with it, right? Like they have to deal with this board.
Astler is probably not good enough.
No. They also have to take some trades, and it's awkward. The 3-6 probably survives most time. Yeah. As long as we keep our stuff, I think we turn the corner mostly.
That's fine.
Yeah. Let's take a trade here. I'm even happier. How much do they have left? Like 6 cards?
Yeah.
So 5 now?
Yeah.
Okay. Not.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, that doesn't really cut it.
I mean, what, it's a 6-6 now?
Yeah.
7-7?
No, it's still a 6-6.
Okay. So. 8-8. 9-9? Wow. Okay.
That was a good turn.
That was their whole, that was their push, right? Like.
Yeah.
How
do we beat that?
Do we just drop an Astalor and a Dirty Rat? Like. Or do we take a trade? Is there a way to, like, unless we just want to discover, like, Vizier, right?
Kill the 9-9. I like that.
And then just throw down the 6-6 if we, or the.
We're probably going to get something. That's fine.
Death Strike, just.
Just Glacial and Death Strike?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. I don't mind
that
now. Or even just Amalgam. Find another Undead, maybe another Vizier.
Dirty Rat pulls either a 5-5 or an 8-8.
I don't want to give them either of those on the board coming into their turn.
Yeah, I feel like just Amalgam.
Yeah, put more on the board. They don't have Taunt. It's Skeletal, right? Like.
This guy, Necromancer?
We have a location? No, we don't run the location.
No.
Right,
no.
So it's gotta be the, yeah, that one. They're not,
I mean, we're never playing it. Yeah. I guess we might. It soaks up. I don't know.
I think it's just, yeah, it's just more pressure. They're gonna probably drop the other 5-5 here.
Yeah.
And then we just Gnome and Necro?
Probably.
Yeah, okay. So it's 2.
4-4.
Okay. Oh, I like that.
I like that too.
Yeah, let's see what that gives us. Like blood, I mean,
like blood boil.
Corpse is 3, and then yeah, we can't play the gnome here.
I'm thinking we either take blood boil and full clear this board, or corpse explosion and then dirty rat.
I like full clear 3, 4, 5. We can play the wandering after that.
No, because we got a hero power.
Yeah, this will cost 3. It costs 3.
No, it's from this guy.
Me. Right, never mind. Okay, yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
It was a 6.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then they're just gonna ask the war here, but that's fine.
To. Yeah. And then
we can.
Do something.
We can Astalor and Secret, right? Or something.
Astalor Secret, yeah. Oh my goodness. No, I was playing this exact match in Hero, and they found the Countess after clearing their deck.
Oh.
And that was not fun. I won. But it was not fun.
You didn't enjoy it.
No, not at all. Okay, yeah.
Expected. A through 3.
Yeah. Every day of the week.
Dirty Rat.
Dirty Rat, yeah, 100%. And then we just Soul Stealer and just end the game. Yeah, sweet. Cool.
Yeah. Nice. Fun.
Alright. Almost out of cards. So, what did they discover off of the...
Better not have been the Countess.
It might be Countess, dude. They're drawing like it's Countess. Like, not gonna be happy if it's Countess. No, okay, it's not Countess. Alright, bet.
Oh, we're safe, we're safe.
What is
it's their random potion? Oh.
Circle. I will be your
death. Oh, oh boy. Congrats on the win, bud.
Thanks, Saku.
Love ya.
Love you too. Back up to my booth. Yeah, in a minute. Mm-hmm. Well, that was pretty interesting. So, kind of a 50-50 according to VS Stats. So, Great Big 3 coming in with the big win for their Blood DK. So, those of you who are just joining us, this is a trio series. So, we are going to be listening to the players navigate their way through. It's Conquest format as well. So, once a team wins with their class, then they can't use that class anymore and have to win up to 3 games. So, thanks to everybody that's tuning in on a Friday night. Hopefully, everybody's being safe and drinking responsibly. So, don't know what Great Big 3 are going to bring out next. I'm going to assume it's going to be Priest. Could see the Rogue come back out for the L gang. Just wait for the players to queue up. So Priest for the L gang. Would have done better against the Death Knight. But maybe not the XL version of it. But yeah, so Priest would probably be a good choice here. So they also have Demon Hunter, which is not good into... Well, they don't have to worry about another Death Knight, because that's off the board. So it's just Priest and Rogue. They got a 50-50 chance, so... So... Type in chat of what you think is going to happen in the next turn, or the next game 2. So, we're waiting. Anybody that's interested in more trios, you might be able to find some more games coming in tomorrow night. I believe it's at 9:30, but you can keep your eyes on the THL Discord. My good buddy Wild9 is going to have some people on with him. I'm not sure if it's Dankstad or if somebody else is joining him for the cast. All right, the game has started. We are going to join the L Gang voice chat, so jump in there right now.
Yeah, that seems about right.
I'm really bad at guess the age, so I'm going to leave you to...
We do not keep Exile. I looked at the stats. We do not keep Exile.
But, like, Exile, Fierce, like, we get a cheap card here. We play this on turn 1.
Such a bad...
Absolutely not.
And...
We do not keep that.
Okay, fine.
You want the one cost cards?
Alright. Yeah, I know.
Our hand's a little threat light, so we're gonna have to be swinging the board back against them.
They kept 3.
That's not good.
We're just gonna high roll.
Do they have any one drops? Yes, they do.
Yes.
It doesn't matter.
Like, they have like 8. They have like 10 one drops, I think.
We play the one drop on 1, guys.
I think we do too. That makes sense to me. All right. So we know how much our Wallopers cost. That's 1.
Yeah. No, they cost
like Quine, Armstealer.
Wait,
egg.
Wallopers are 10 base, right? Coin, Undying, Armstealer, Egg.
I shouldn't have said anything.
Come on.
Is there a turn over yet? I think it's over. Wow, that took a while, bro. That was a joke. I think we play To place him.
Well, if we hit security, it's really good. Right. We kill the arms dealer. If we hit
next
outsider,
turn,
we kill the arms dealer.
Next turn is Theno. We need spectral sight to try and draw predation, right? What was your, what were you saying?
If we, I mean, if we think that if we care about killing the arms dealer this turn, like there's two really good hits that from the studies that can kill the arms dealer.
I just know he has a two drop as well, right? What is a two drop?
I mean, they kept
it's the Volgum.
Amalgam Shadow
Ascendant. I don't really care though. Like we still.
I think. All right. Say so.
I mean, we need predation, right? What?
I mean.
Felrin, we win. See, yeah, we traded.
We trade.
Yeah, we trade. Yeah, egg. Egg. We don't want the egg to pop, so we trade.
Off the top.
No, that was off the top. See, so therefore my. Okay.
There's security. Good.
Security killed the two.
Yep, security. We kill the.
Then we play.
Well, we'll see what we hit off the studies, and then we'll decide. Because we can hit, hit outsider off the studies, right?
I don't want to get like.
No, I mean we do it second, but like we'll decide what the trades because we can hit outsider off study.
Oh, you mean that? Okay.
Yeah. We're not. Yeah, Sigil Runner. Right. The other two are not going to get played.
They will never catch me. You have
probably.
To kill it.
Fine.
Yeah.
We could have disposed. No, we're not. We need to wait for Senna.
Next
is Felrin. Alright, Felrin on 4, Steno on 5. And we're fine.
Yeah.
And at some point, like, Wallopers will find their way into our hand.
Yeah, we're looking okay. The egg is scary.
I mean, given that they played the nuttiest turn one.
They did.
Possible.
They did. Yeah.
And then
those, I believe, the three best cards in the mulligan for that deck. Arms dealer, egg, allies.
Well, no,
I don't know allies
is
the best.
They didn't keep it. They top decked it. So that means it's, like, even better because...
Oh, which of those cards are the top one?
Grave digging. That's not what they kept, is it?
Surely not.
No, they still kept something on the. Did they play that from the left? Did anyone pay attention?
I am not paying attention. It wasn't from the right.
Okay, so. Just Felrin.
Yeah.
We
just Felrin here.
Steno, but. It is our time to step
out of the shadow. Ooh.
Oh wow, we just killed both the sages of evidence.
Nutty.
Oh,
yeah, it's just sages and outsider.
I mean, we could dispose once. Dispose the other. No, we don't even want that.
No, that doesn't make sense.
We dispose the other dispose. Then we can.
What?
Then we can play sage, get a 2 mana Steno plus a 1 mana spectral sight.
I'm just playing the rusher.
Is that not nuts though?
Yeah, I think you just played the rusher here.
Oh, sure. I'm definitely playing this, right? It's a 2/2.
Well, if you were gonna play it,
oh,
you want to play it second, right?
I know. I think I just play dispose here.
I don't know. I don't know that.
This is good. That's good, no?
Yeah, because now we get okay. Sight.
Okay. What if we missed on the second dispose though?
We didn't.
We didn't.
We
that
didn't.
True.
Don't worry.
We didn't.
I could never hit miss because it's either.
We have Gimme Lamp. Gimme Lamp is present, so we knew we wouldn't miss.
Mm.
If Gimme Lamp was not present, we would have perhaps considered alternatives.
So we do it the other way.
What are they thinking about?
We have. I guess this is fine.
Hey, they didn't. Fine. They don't have the card. That one card.
Yeah, they don't have the basilisk.
Alright, so just play cards.
Do we start with Vicious Slither Spear? I don't think we do.
Oh, no.
You just play as many spells as possible.
Draw or I-beam?
I-beam, right?
I like the I-beam.
Okie dokie. We can play Spectral. Actually, Spectral's better because we...
Yeah, we play Spectral side.
There you go.
Wait, I should have... Oh, dang it.
Yeah, a little sloppy.
I'm stupid head. Okay.
Is there, then she hits a Mind
this
Eater.
This definitely goes here.
Okay. We kill...
Wallopers that they can't play.
Bro, we just ignore this other one. We go face with Felon, right?
Yes.
Yeah, we go face with Felon 100%.
Okay!
Alright, our hand's empty.
We'd have an extra 2-2 if I wasn't stupid, right? Just confirming.
Yeah.
Yes, well, it'd be a 2-1. Wait,
indeed.
No, it has no attack, so yeah, no, it would be a 2-2.
Yup.
But they always hit like double wall.
Please don't fire me, team.
So and we hit spectrals right off the top here.
We already played both.
We generated. One of them were generated, right?
No, it wasn't. We played both special size.
No, because we can.
Oh no.
Was one study. Oh no, you're right. Celerin gave us the outsider in the sage. Yeah.
So, wait, what are we top deck? What is this deck? Helveria. Studies. Yeah. Glaivetar.
Stage.
We still have Glaivetar in the deck. Don't forget. It's good stuff. Also, they don't have the card. The other card. You know what I'm talking about.
The Shadow Run Death.
Yes, you knew exactly what I was talking about, see? Yeah.
Nope.
That one. They didn't have it. So
I do play the game from time to time.
Wait, and they took they have another demon oh that's both demon hunter cards.
Not a bad draw.
Heartstone is fun.
Yep. We take they asked me to just take the VT, right?
VT.
Yeah, over the Ascendant.
That was like. That was a big word. Alright, this trades and then this trades.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah. Because we know, we suspect they don't have the big bad card.
You sounded disgusted, Lamp.
This sucks.
You didn't like that trade?
No, he means bump at the end. I was hovering
That I might retch if you made that bump.
I wasn't gonna do it, guys. Come on.
Surely not. All right.
Okay. Now we get something off the top.
Studies into spectral sight into something.
Studies into spectral sight.
Studies into sight into Glaivetar.
Glaivetar. Yep. Or
rush the stage is good here. Very good here as well.
Rush the stage. I forgot about that one. What's this last card? It's not undeath, right?
I mean, they would have played the undeath.
True. I don't want to take 6 damage, but
no, you do not.
We could take 6 damage. Really felt like it.
Can
we full
three
clear?
Damage.
We can full clear. Yeah. Two. This bumps. This bumps. This. Yeah. Yes, we. We can. We can do it.
Yeah, you're only taking 3 damage.
This bumps, right?
Well, don't we want the other one to die because it has the 1/1 death rattle, or do we care about that? No. Let's do it the other way. Let's do it the first way with the slither on the right into the necromancer. Yeah. Yep. There we go. Yep. All right.
Okay.
You wouldn't dare. You would not dare.
It's an undead, so it's not Basileth ever, right?
Basileth's not an undead.
It's not?
For some reason, it's not. I guess because they don't want you discovering it, I would imagine.
Ooh.
Maybe there's some WoW nerd reason. I don't know.
Alright, we just don't.
I guess we just leave up the spirit and kill the 4/5. Yeah.
But we could kill it, though.
We could, but...
Yeah, but then we don't really have much of a board.
Yeah, we trade away our board and give them, like, the damage. So good. Yeah. Man, Hawk Shredder Rancher is a hell of a card.
I think maybe we do.
I think we just start smorking.
We go... I think we go... I agree with Lamb. Because, like, if they want their thing to die, they have to kill our 6/2. Because if we trade,
we want them to trade,
we have a 1/1 and a 6/2.
Oh, okay.
Do we race them? Let's do we race them?
I don't think
there is only one punish, and it's undeath.
We go face. They go to 19, and we still have 10 power on board.
Actually, yeah,
I think we go face.
No, we trade because of capital. Or yeah, no, we trade.
Thank you.
Because both undeath and Cathedral are
okay.
Nutty.
Fine.
Because
undeath,
of Cathedral,
undeath for reasons,
right? Yeah, well, Cathedral and undeath.
They never
they
had.
Play
undeath. They
it's
kind of
grim anyway, right? We have no board and we're at like 6 HP.
Oh my gosh!
You see?
See? Yeah. Now we win, right?
Yeah, we win. Yeah, now we win because we made that play.
Oh, let's go!
Oh. The comeback.
Oh, yo. Baby.
Okay. Never second undeath or necromancer.
No, undeath doesn't kill us though.
Mind seer.
Actually, we just lose to undeath. You still do. Mind seer? No.
No more burn.
Oh wait, do they run it? Do they run mind seer? I have no clue.
Yes.
What's an undeath.
Yes.
Yeah, they have.
Yes, they run mind seer.
All right. Well, he's holding something, so it's undeath, right? No, he wouldn't hold undeath, right? He would want us to have no minions to I-beam.
Correct.
Yeah,
so
he's
what is he considering holding?
Undying allies.
Egg? No, he played both undying. He played both undying allies. Okay. Wait.
We hear power first, right?
Yeah. Sure. X.
Yeah.
Well.
King.
We play the exile, right? Because like,
yep.
If he can kill this, we're dead anyway.
Correct.
We don't. We already played Senno, so.
Yeah, predation is good. Ahead. Spend the 3 mana. All right, no burn.
I mean, he would.
No burn.
If he held something, it has to be undead. I just don't know why he would do it.
No, the top deck. The top deck.
Oh,
okay.
He always misses.
No,
yeah.
The whole deck is undead. Yeah, if we had like a single outcast. We're playing outcast DH. He's playing undead priest. It's only fair that he got his undead, but we didn't get our outcast. So
we ran out of cards.
Well, that was unfortunate. Ran out of gas at the end. But I think they made the right plays with what cards they were given in the top deck at the end there for the great big three. Got him through. So priest is in. So that's great big three up 2-0 over the L gang. So now we're gonna see what the other stuff is left. So rogue for great big three to try and win their match going up against priest. So we're gonna jump in their channel here in a quick second. Want to thank everybody again for joining the THL Friday Night Fights match, the trio series. Let's join the great big three, which is actually only 2 tonight. So,
Sinstone is 95% keep and a 54% win rate in hand versus priest.
Okay, we keep it.
I think we keep it, dude.
Toss the scribe, the scribbling.
Yeah, no, we don't want any of that. We want stuff for the graveyard.
Well, we got it anyways.
Sad face. This is in fact not what we wanted.
Hit him in the face for 1 on turn 1.
Worth it to fucking... No, I feel like the graveyard's how we win this match, right?
Yeah.
Like, we have to have a decent pop-off turn. Right, yeah. Kind of felt like... Oh my gosh. Okay. Ugh.
Oh, that's fine.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Well played. Do we play that and strike the egg?
We play that. No, I don't think we care with the egg, right? Because he's just going to play like Shadow. So we want to do something to deal with that. So, like, the deal, we want deal three. Mm-hmm. Like, for next turn.
Yeah.
We want to take... Yeah.
We play this, right?
Yeah. For sure.
Do we shoot?
Yeah, our hand is so dead right now.
I think we shoot the egg, though.
I mean, he's just going to fit. I guess we could just hero power down. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fine.
Oh, my.
Okay. I mean,
we go. This is just so slow.
I know. Redraw.
Vocation?
Yeah.
It's not that fast, I guess.
And you're trading, so I'm having not trading.
We'd like a Shadow Step here. Sinstone, well, we can.
Yeah. Then we're probably going to Pojack.
Yeah. Hit him.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. There's no point to trade that trade. Oh, that concoction is brutal.
Slimy.
Three or destroy a random would have been way better.
Even we would have taken draw or...
Draw, yeah. I mean, a ghoul would be a nut off the top here or like a bone, right? Oh, wow. Okay.
Drop the... I think we dropped the pose that...
Really?
This turn and then go off next turn.
Okay. Yeah, okay. I mean, they're just gonna play one of these bots, right?
We're fine with that, though.
Yeah, so like, prep, bail, see what concoctions we get. Hopefully deal three or kill. Then how many is that played? One, two... Three, it's not enough to play a steno behind it. Who would be the nuts here, or a bone spike?
Once, yeah, all of those sound awesome.
Another crap I wouldn't even mind, to be honest. Okay, this is...
Oh. Okay, prep belt.
Yeah.
I think we want draw.
Ooh, really?
That's, I think we need
mixed with the one in our hand, right?
Oh, you're right.
So deal three is at least we kill the bot 100%, and then we trade into the egg. So because deal like the random could be the 1-2, right? We want the deal three.
We'd want the I just feel like we want to get these rushes out this turn.
Okay, but you think drawing is going to be better for that?
Yeah, because okay, well, if we pick this, yeah. And then just draw again.
Okay.
Or do you want... Maybe we can just pick the damage on this one.
That's fine. We can do whatever. I mean, you know what? No, pick the draw. Pick the draw, because we've got in case we have... in our deck.
No, Mike.
Oh. Rip that. It's not enough, though, right? Unless you get a prep or a step.
Oh, that is brutal. Kill the egg?
Yeah, we have to. Yeah.
Oh, that's brutal.
That's brutal. Oh, wow. Dead. Probably Shadow Word undead here.
Yeah. Damn. I don't know.
If we high rolled, it was worth it, but I mean, we do have Krabatoa.
Yeah.
That was unfortunate that we couldn't get one more.
But still having double Shadow Step and a prep. I mean, Krabatoa is really, really, really good here. I know we're almost dead, but...
We're super dead. Like, they just need to ping us a few times. And yeah, like, we can crab, obviously, we have to, but...
Yeah. Damn.
I mean, that's just supposed to happen, right? We can't win every unfavorable.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, I don't even know if it would have mattered if we got the rushes out. We take less damage there.
We would have taken way less damage.
That's true, and then we would have had a 6-6, or we would have had an 8-8, or 8-4.
Actually, we would have had a 9-9, because we would have played a zero cost.
That's true, yeah.
So, yeah. I think it would have made a world of difference. But you're right, I think we had to go for it there. The undead
yeah.
Card.
This can miss.
Good.
And then I could get zero damage.
It makes me think that it did miss.
Wow.
Okay.
Need to Astalor by next turn.
Okay.
What's
hey,
this?
The Leaf scored. Let's go, baby.
Bone Flayer. Okay.
We gotta get these rushes out, right?
Yeah, but I'm just thinking, do you think they picked Shadowward Undeath?
To kill us. But, I mean, if they do, we can't. We have to clear the board anyways. They have Shadowward Undeath. There's nothing we can do.
We can Azure into Tidestones to try and hit, like...
No. Absolutely not. I think we need to play cards out of our
Okay. Game. We're drawing, doing Dora yeah. First.
Yes.
Concoctions?
Can we want to the shadow step though, right? Can we? No, can we not?
Or do we want to do this door?
Sure, start going. We don't have a lot of time.
Yeah.
Oh, bone spike.
Bone spike. Gonna. Oh man.
All right.
Send this face.
Gonna play these rushes and send them to that minion. The other rush, hit the button.
Hit the button, hit face. Sets up lethal, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I
should have gotten. Should have gotten this off. It could have gotten something to save us.
Yeah, I think we have the time. This is what we need to do. It's either undeath and we lose, or.
Yeah, or this. Double, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, either way, it didn't matter. Okay, cool. Well, whatever. Wait, what?
Yeah.
Oh, deal three. Yeah, okay. I was like, wait. Yeah, alright, whatever. That was gonna happen. And they got one. They got one on us.
Yeah, like, we still got the... Isn't there one?
Well, that was good. Lemur and the gang winning with the big bad priest, so... Not the best draw for the great big three, but that's Hearthstone for you. What can you say? Can't always have the best cards all the time. Or maybe you can. Chat can tell us. Chat can tell us of what our percentages are for having the best cards all the time. So, 60%, what do you think? So now we're going to be jumping back into the Elgang's chat as soon as they start up here. I'm assuming they're going to go with Demon Hunter. Going up against Rogue, and I am correct for once, so let's jump back into the Elgang's chat here. We're on game 4 of a best of 5, so.
Nuts!
Wait. Yeah.
They run in front of knives, by the way.
Yep.
They... Yeah.
They do.
Ooh. One drop on one. We might actually play one drop on one.
Yeah, we do play it on one. Because they have to one ghostly strike to kill it.
Or just...
Yeah, well, it's concocted, so we study. No, security hero power. That's nuts. Then they play Phantom Knives. Yeah, is there a way we could just like avoid Phantom Knives? Like,
yeah, just say they will literally never draw Phantom Knife.
Dude, yeah. You know what?
Yeah, it's just, I mean, you just studies.
Oh, please just keep it in your hand, man.
They step the concoctor?
Yeah, because they have ghoulish in hand, they want to make sure they get it out.
Alright, well, we play that instead.
Okay, if they're playing, if they're not playing Fan next turn, because they're playing Ghoulish, so we know.
Yeah.
We just gotta hope that he don't.
Do we not just want to Ildari studies?
No, we security first. Like, we don't care about the. We
oh, don't trade. Security. Don't trade? Okay. Bet.
Fuck them, they don't have Fan.
They don't. Well, they didn't set up for Fan. Like, this step concoction.
No, I mean, they can always just play it. Like, if they have it, they play it. They ignore their Alchemist plan and just play Fan and Knives.
Yeah.
All right, we got spider.
That'd
tank.
Be good to step right there.
Yeah, that would be complete bullshit.
They should kill the 2/1.
Yeah. So oh, then we just want to stay as wide as possible for Helvaria.
Kill the 2/1.
Yeah. No, we have to stay wide.
Yeah.
Well, we know they don't have Fan. And they don't, yeah. I mean, as we've seen, they're not able to top deck anything. Am I right? Am I right, guys? Yeah.
Yep, exactly.
Well, what if we, I guess we play Slither first. Yeah, we play Slither.
High beam.
Is it Spectral?
Yeah, I like High beam.
High beam or Spectral? I mean, they can only trade into one.
It's a good question, actually.
Because if we High beam, we can kill the Blightfang while killing with our runner, so we keep 2 rushers and we have Helvaria in hand.
Or we just kill the 3/2 and go face with the rest.
Yeah, that's another option.
You know what? Yeah, we do have Helvaria. That might mean we play IBM.
Or but in that case, we just outsider. If we're getting the 3/2.
Yeah, I think if you outsider, you leave the most minions alive. Same amount of rush minions. You get to keep the 1/1.
Oh, because we can hear power as well.
Well, we hear power face, right? Because you're just gonna trade the 2/1.
I like this better. I'm sorry.
Or you do it like that.
Yeah, no. That's good.
No, yeah, this is better. Yeah, I like this. You miss a damage, but you keep a rush, an extra rush.
Yeah,
minion.
And he has to play location here if he has, or he wants to play location here. So this is it's hard for him to actually deal with this.
And they're not top decking Fan of Knives, so.
Yeah, no, this is good.
Yeah. Ideally, Helvaria is just backbreaking.
I mean, this like telegraphs that we have Helvaria though. So.
Yeah, but they're playing around.
What are they gonna do about it?
Like.
Yeah, that's true.
If they have Fan of Knives, they would have played it already.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna go get some chicken. I'll be back in a second.
If they top deck it, not to, like. You know, not telegraphing it doesn't save us. So.
Yeah. But, like, even if we don't telegraph it, they're going to play around it.
Interesting. Hopefully it comes back before
okay.
We rip out.
What do we do? Do we play Helvaria or Glaivetar?
We play Helvaria, right? Buff
yes.
Up the board. You go
play
face
Walloper.
With. Nah, we just Helvaria.
Dude.
Yeah, you play Helvaria. You go face.
Oh, we don't trade the Helvaria though.
No, because she dies.
So.
What if we go face twice and then trade the Helvaria? Like use the 2 rushers face.
Wait, no, we do one. We do one face.
Definitely, you play the Helvaria and one of them goes face, right? And then you.
I just like Walloper. Or we could Glaivetar trade. I like Walloper way better here.
Yeah, I do argue with Walloper.
Really? Okay.
We could.
You're saying that they still have not had a way to answer it? I don't know.
Well, I just don't. I don't want to kill Helvaria. Like.
Yeah, no,
just
I,
for like 3
I
extra
would
damage.
Be well up her.
As we play Helvaria, we would go. We could like, you go face with one Illidari. You can trade in the other.
Yeah, but like Halberdier right now doesn't deal that much extra damage.
And we have an opportunity to get a lot of value out of Halberdier, assuming we stick something later on. We can just play Halberdier along with like a
security.
Yeah. And because we have Glaivetar, so like we can wait a little bit. I don't know if it was correct to trade the Walloper in, or if I could have hero powered into it. Like,
hero power in 1/1.
I like using the Walloper because it's a wider board.
Yes.
Yeah,
I agree.
That is true. I'm just scared of Serrated, but they would have played Serrated, so. I mean, he could still, like, the one damage thing. But. Pozic. I was thinking Pozic here. Wow. So his hand is like Grab 100%, Ashara 100%. Then like, what? Door?
Yeah, the other Ghoulish.
It's like Door. Stuff. Yeah, they can't get a big. Dude. Holy. Yeah, they're never getting a big location anymore. That's okay though for them. It can, like,
that's
an Augur.
Yeah, but like.
Alright, okay, go. Glaivetar.
Do we trade the Glaivetar into that, or just go face?
We'll see if we draw.
Okay, you're right, we should just draw first. Nice. Wow!
I think
it's face.
They're at 19, I think we just go to the head.
Holy, dude.
We have so much rush.
That was like the best possible two cards, I swear.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
And they're,
they
this is
better
Ashara
in the other position.
They're playing Ashara.
Probably. And then hopefully we don't get blown out by the
doesn't
colossal.
Matter. No, unless it's like black the priest one. Aside from that, it doesn't even matter. What?
Kolak would be rough.
What is their hand?
Bad.
There's no way they didn't like misplay it or something. Like what is so like there's the only expensive cards.
Maybe it's just bad one cost spells like Door and stuff.
There's no way, like, if you know what I think they did? I think they have location. No, they don't.
There's no way they have a location.
Right, I mean, because it made sense for them not to play on 3. But I guess there's no excuse for them. And then they couldn't get the stenographer down until like last turn unless they played enough cards. They might actually just have location hand. They never got the chance.
Oh shit!
That doesn't matter. We can kill it with Felerin.
Yeah, but they can kill us with it.
Not this turn. They already spent all their steps and stuff. There's their fan. This is okay, we lethal them next turn, right? So it's just Felerin here.
We Felerin.
It is our time to step out of the shadow. Sigil Runner.
Ooh. Yep, Sigil Runner. They will never
catch me. I-beam.
Yeah, I-beam.
Can we play another Sigil Runner?
It's Sigil Runner versus like digging for a if we find studies off the Glaivetar draw, we can find a an outsider and kill the Steno. Otherwise, we have to punch into the Steno to kill it.
How are we beating
Crab next about the Steno?
No, we don't care. They're playing Crab next turn.
We I-beam the 4-2 and go full face. Like, we even hero power
face. I just
hope
we have enough burn. I guess we have Steno, and we could get, like, predation shit, so. So, we, so that means, if that's the case, we play... Where do we hero
power? Yeah, we play the 1-1.
I like hero power to set them to 9.
Okay, well, I didn't do that, sorry.
Sure.
We get another draw, too. It's another spell for the Steno, or another shot at predation on your dispose. And the Walloper. Alright, dead Steno.
It's not Steno, it's 4-4. Right? They're playing Crab. Crab is the only thing that beats us, anyway.
What if they don't play Crab?
Then we don't care.
I'm coming to 4-4. I think it's Crab.
Actually, that's worse than 2 second Fan of Knife.
They clearly have Crab in hand. There's no way. They had like
they could play their other 4 cards, right? Or 5 cards.
But they're not burning us down. We'd rather that happen because then that's
But they can like clear
minions.
Our board.
Yeah, but they're not killing us. Unless like they super high roll. Well, okay. They're not killing us. Like Crab is like the worst case, and I thought that we'd just win if it's not Crab. But maybe I'm wrong. Because we have Steno, Halberdier, no, Steno. Yeah, maybe you're right. I don't know.
Because she's already dealt.
I just thought, like, if he didn't have crab, then we just win anyways. But I might have been. Yeah, I think I might have. Been.
I mean, I think we're favored from this position.
Don't have much. Okay, well that. Okay. Please hit the 1-1. Yay. Well, yeah, but now they don't get to go face with the other one. They have to swing into the 5-1. And now we can. Oh, gosh. That's cool. We can Steno. We Steno pop off?
But we only have two spells. So which,
This is free.
It's just the
stage prediction phase.
How many rush minions do we have? How many outsiders have we had
the
one in
the
opener?
We just have the 2-1, I think.
Do we have? Did we draw the second one?
We already played both. Well.
Steno rush the stage predation.
Vicious slither spear.
Yeah.
Steno rush the stage.
Yeah, but I mean, afterward.
Are we? Yeah, hopefully we don't feed them. Concoctions.
I don't really think we care. They already
they
have
hand. A full hand, I think.
We could keep. No, it doesn't matter. I mean, we could place.
I think we could trade into the stealth. Trade first.
What? Why?
I like trading if you wanted to be stealth for a 50-50 shot of clearing it.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, at what point are they just playing crab though?
I mean,
I don't think they're going to do that.
Dude, did I mess up when I never killed it the first time?
Yes.
thanks, man.
We have a lot of outs right now.
We just play Wretched Exile into like IBM. There's no way, dude. I should have killed it.
There's no way the rogue would play a bunch of cheap spells. No way, bro.
I should have killed it, man.
Alright, so we're gonna get dispels.
I thought it was like guaranteed crab because
okay,
I didn't play anything.
I get
anything.
It. That stenographer was mad dogging you. I understand.
How many cards do we have?
He's got 4 attack, and the other one had 2. So I was like, you know what? It's probably better. God,
okay.
Damn it.
Okay.
What?
Leroy, how many cards in deck?
10!
Yeah, we have like a 1 in 3 shot of getting lethal, basically.
Dude, they're gonna kill us right now!
No. Like, I will simply refuse to die.
There's no way! Okay. Oh, okay, alright, we're alive. Okay, alright, what is it? Studies? Alright, Wretched Exile?
Yeah, Exile.
You can play it second, right? You can discover first.
Okay, yeah.
Draw.
That is a... Wait, is it? Wait.
It's...
Can I see the board, please?
I think it's Runner.
Runner? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. We need I-beams. I-beam, yes.
We killed the...
We don't care about the future side. Yeah, it has to be. We hit the Steno.
Yeah.
We hit the Steno. Yep. Let's play the Spectral Sight. Yes. Don't we punch?
No, we don't want to punch because we still want more. We still want more outcast cards.
Nice. Very good.
And now we have guaranteed lethal next turn.
We do?
Yeah, because we have dispels in deck.
You're right. Well, I already played 1. Oh yeah, because we have. Okay, you're right.
Yeah,
okay, you know what? Again. You know what? Okay, you know what? I didn't kill the Steno. And then if we,
What if I play crab?
No.
Crab is fine.
They don't have. They don't even have crab still. Oh, he's armored.
I know they haven't had.
Wait, no, it
time.
Doesn't matter if he armors. If he armors, we play Helverian lethal anyway, right? So. Is Helverian lethal?
I think it depends on dollar draws.
Oh, there's no way. We just. Oh, exile. Alright.
How many cards in deck?
We have 1-3 damage, so it's not there. So we can go Helveria plus security.
Helveria.
I go ranch your Helveria.
Yeah, we have to ranch your Helveria. Yeah.
Oh, buddy. Oh, man. Oh, shucks. We can play this.
Yeah. Actually, no. No, we can't. We have to security.
We can security. Anyway. Oh, their next outcast card. You're right. I'm stupid.
Yeah, we have to security here.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Right. All right. Okay. So this. What? This is going into that, so.
Yeah, that goes there.
Or one, two. We could actually keep the Helveria on board.
We don't.
Okay.
We want. Actually, do we?
We can't keep it.
Yeah, we can.
Yeah.
We can't. Well, we have to full trade. We don't get to go face with the Sigil Runner. Which is important considering we have all burn.
We're back to the same spot. We can still hit lethal next turn. Crab is not lethal. Did he play all the concoctions? Dude, this no deck tracker. This is like
he probably has a bunch of concoctions left.
Oh yeah, he has a ton of concoctions. I forgot he played the future side. Okay.
If they had concoction lethal last turn, they would have won for it.
Yes, yeah, true. But they might have double damage with crab now. True.
The crab's gonna end it, surely. Finally.
There's no way that my playing around crab led to us dying because they drew crab. This is not possible. It's not really, like
it's always the crab angle.
Go for the mirror.
Huh?
True. Lamp. This is all because you didn't listen to lamp. He said you didn't go for the mirror.
No, dude. This is it. Like if we win here, it's gonna be the best game five.
They clearly don't have 9 damage in hand. Oh,
he's getting the priest colossal.
Oh anyway, wait, no, are they gonna do double 3?
He's getting the priest colossal.
No.
Even if it is, it's gonna pull the 1/1.
Okay, we're
fine.
You win. Even if it is, it's gonna kill the 1/1.
They can hit Kolak. Kolak would have won the game from there.
Kolak would have. Maybe. I mean, we had Richard anyway.
Just go.
Alright, there we go.
Okay.
Easy video game, never in doubt.
Game 5 has been granted, guys. Congrats.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes.
Yeah, we're going for the reverse.
There you go.
Rogue versus Rogue.
I'll be right back.
Well, there we go. You want a Game 5? You got the Game 5. So, Rogue versus Rogue with Rogue shenanigans. Some great work there by Lemur being paranoid for Krapatoa, and rightfully so. But it all worked out at the end. So there you go. Game 5. Best words in all of THL Hearthstone matches. Of course, get some Game 5s and spammed in chat there when everybody's ready to go. So, just had Yachtster step away for a quick sec. Probably take a quick breather, get reorientated to go back and start high rolling with Rogue. So, yeah. So, if you're just fresh joining us, the Great Big Three were up 2-1. And the L Gang is now currently fought back the last two games and dragging this into a Game 5 situation. So I'm going to try and hop back and forth between the two teams, but I might be a little bit distracted trying to keep things going. But we're going to jump into the Great Big Three's channel to listen to what they're going to do, and then a couple of games or a couple rounds into it, we'll jump into the other channel of the L Gang. So. Let's listen in.
No point in playing that.
Is there, though? Like, we need our Sinstone, right? Like, if it's on the bottom of the deck? I don't know.
I guess.
I feel we need the Sinstone, and it's like, if it's on the bottom, then yeah, this is just gonna...
You like it?
Next turn. Yeah, because we could just tutor our next draw, right? Never pose, actually. Leave that thing in the bottom of the deck.
What do you think?
Shadows.
Mm-hmm. Well, the tombstones aren't there. Since stones.
They could be fourth down, right?
Yeah.
Lovely.
Fan?
Yeah. Yeah, just start drawing.
There we are.
Okay. Sorry, I just blocked our Sinstone off the top, but you know.
Play it.
Yeah.
1-1, you. Mm-hmm.
Did it ever putrescide, like, ghostly, and then, like, do we just make a 4-4?
Yeah, I think it's okay. And then ghostly, and then gone fishing, and then... Yeah.
Doesn't matter. Ooh.
I'm fishing.
Yeah.
Ghostly?
I honestly like ghostly, maybe just to prep to ghostly. Yeah. Just make another big.
It ain't much.
We'll see if it's big enough.
Yeah. I mean, this is kind of nice to have, I guess.
Guys, calm down. We're on stream. Calm down.
We want to start with coinfish, right?
Yeah, coinfish. Yeah.
Yep, probably right. We're gonna go like. Pressed. Yeah.
Belt. Gone fishing.
Don't you worry about the belt.
We could.
Yeah, we fish. Yeah, we fish.
We prep the belt. We prep the belt. Okay. Yeah you're right. We should have fished. You're right. Ah, okay. Draw?
Yeah, draw. Deadly?
Okay. We can't.
Yeah.
Wait, we do this.
Yeah, we fish first. First, we're going to get concoctor. Oh, damn it.
We should have drawn first. What did I say? Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah, it's regular.
Alright.
We have a larger one.
Now they play a shark.
Yep.
We just, like, surreal it and, like, I don't know, stuff.
No, like, Ashara, Deadly is actually so good if they hit that. So we go Concoctor. We go Concoctor. Yeah, we just. They don't have Ashara. They have Crab, right? You know what? Like, I'm done making assumptions on their hand based on their, like strange early plays. I've lost my touch.
Yeah, that fishing is odd. Oh, that was a really good hit off the Mind Eater.
Oh, that was a really good hit off of... Wait, that wasn't even a belt, was it? That was a belt, actually. Yeah, it was a belt. Right.
Asalor?
No, we Astolor step Astolor like next turn.
Well, we bone spike it, right? We bone spike it out.
We need to, do that though.
Where do we belt?
We just kind of take. We could take this damage.
Do you want to take? I mean, we need to kill the 6-2, right? We got to kill the 6-2. But maybe do you think it's worth saving the bone spike for an extra stat on Ghost next turn?
We belt.
I don't know about that. Probably deadly here.
Yeah, and
we could double destroy.
Damage.
I think we should double destroy.
No, we're gonna get 3 damage. Trust.
Well, no, this is mixing with this one.
Oh. All right, then.
I don't know why I did that. Okay, fine, whatever.
Bone spike that. Yep.
Do we ever bone spike the assault to guarantee they can't step it?
Probably not. Probably kill the, yeah.
Oh my god, it's nutty. Alright.
Yeah, normally the, like, the 8 mana Ash Lords are not really how this matchup goes.
No, yeah, it doesn't matter. And next turn we have the steps.
On board way.
Sorry, I think we did a good job there of, like keeping a play for next turn for this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, we used some of our resources to stay alive, but yeah, this looks good. Yeah, I don't think it's worth to hold the bone spike to get a 1-1 on the ghost next turn.
Oh yeah, definitely not.
Particularly when they have a high chance of just like deadly shotting
you. Oh dang. No. They're gonna get the priest. It's Gigafin. It's Gigafin in their hand right now. We're gonna top deck Ashara? You sure? Are you sure?
Good draw.
Okay. I believe you. I was just, wondering, if you're sure. Now that you're sure, I believe you. What is this? 4/4? Not good enough.
No, they're not going to make it, surely.
They don't even...
Ooh.
Not now. Not yet.
Yeah, no, you just asked lower.
Wait, they didn't do it?
No.
That's
we go.
Wrong, right? All right, that's got to be wrong. All right, we ignore this. Go face, right? Face everything? We could shoot it for 2, but they already used a step.
I mean, there's the 2 damage. Will the 2 damage face
matter? They've used Future Side and they've used a Shadow
I guess
step.
It does, like, this is...
Oh, no, Future Side was last game. I'm
this
sorry.
Gets better yeah. if it's dead, so... Fine, I'll do it once.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Not what we wanted to see there.
Do we use that? No.
Do we step the Concoctor?
No, we step past... Wait, do we step the Concoctor? Yeah, we do.
Yeah, we get like...
Let's think about this.
Let's think about it. All right, I did it.
Instant Concoctor.
Prep. Because screw it.
Fuck it, we ball.
Yeah, all right. Fuck it, we ball. I could have used that prep actually, but
it's okay. The 7/7 over the 6/6.
French.
No, why? It's not. What? Why would it be in French?
I don't know, because you're getting Discord notification and it's French.
It's me? I'm not getting Discord notifications. No, this is just streaming Hearthstone. If you're seeing something, it's you.
No, we can see your Discord notification show up on your stream.
No, I haven't had any show up, have I?
Jespin sent some messages.
Oh, Jespin. Did he say, is this a joke? All right, I'm going to see what he says. I think it's a joke, but I'm going to see. I banned DH, but no, it's not that one. No.
I just know that. Jespin sent a message and like...
Come on.
Next time, Jespin sends a message, I'm gonna...
Whoa! Did we win a 50-50?
We yes, dodged. We got some of what
yeah,
they
we play
call
this, luck. Right?
Yeah, we play this.
Yeah.
3...
Krabatoa.
Stop. I don't want them to have Krabatoa. I don't want them to have anything. I want them to hit us in the face and
maybe
don't do anything to our board.
Drop a 3-3. And then turn.
Time and place where I would love them just to hit me in the face, right?
Yeah. Come on. Oh. Or they
Why
could
did
do
you
that.
Wish that into existence, man? I mean, this is just bad. This is just bad. We could still 100% yeah. kill 7/7.
Yeah.
That 4/4 cannot go face. That 4/1 cannot go face. Oh, hey, look at that.
Right on time.
I
don't
use it though.
Yeah, it doesn't do anything this turn. Trade.
Yeah.
Kill it. And Astor.
Yep.
Boo.
They also have an Astor in hand, right?
Yeah. We have Graboteau in the deck, though. That's good draw, and then...
We just need card draw at this point, right? But, like, we use our Ghastlies. I don't even think we have any... I don't think we have anything left, right?
Not really.
Okay. That's awful.
That is quite bad. We can just go like all in here.
Yep.
Do this. Prep.
You just do it all, man. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Play everything.
Prep. Bone spike.
Oh, is that still gonna be cheap enough for the thing to be?
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Okay. I just wanna maybe or Gagger up too.
Yeah.
We can still okay.
Great. Yep. 4/4.
4/4. Alright, well.
We got an Astor here.
9+14 is not lethal.
But it makes gives 14. Them a bad board to. They can't really just Astor right back. Oh.
Oh! Right.
Yes.
Classic. That's classic.
Double draw here. No, wait.
This is not.
Oh.
Why do you keep saying these things?
I'm gonna shut up.
Stop giving them the. Man says. Cravatella. Oh. Of course.
We just got Astor here.
I mean it. Yeah. It's just awful. We just Astor is back, and then we have the super sad. Hey, at least we killed the, Alright, here's how this works. They Astor us back, it literally doesn't kill our guy, they can't kill it, we hit him in the face, and then we somehow discover another third potion belt in our deck, and that gives us double damage, and somehow we win.
Somehow we deal an extra damage in there.
Somehow we deal like an extra one. I'm into it. I'm here for it.
Sinstone gets charged for one turn.
Sinstone's a bum. It will potion belt.
Yeah.
Alright.
Concoction
luck.
What is this card? Do we run it?
Oh, we played it once. Yeah, we played it once.
Uh-huh.
I'm just sad.
Yeah, I'm also very sad. Thought about a lot of things. Wow, right on time.
Oh?
Right on time.
Oh?
Right on any...
Oh?
This is terrible.
This is actually awful because it's an 11 mana turn, and it's just like, I mean, we're not dead, right?
I think we are.
Just stop. Oh, you're doing it that way?
What else are we gonna do?
Oh, I just double fives, but doesn't matter.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah.
Either way, we're taking the four, right? So, I guess.
Either way, yeah. We are dead.
Man, just don't. Man, just hit 2/2. We just slapped the 2/2 down. It's absolute,
we're dead.
Right?
Yeah, we're dead.
It doesn't matter, right? It's exact. Oh, this is also probably just going to kill us. Yeah, that's just. Imagine getting concoctions that did things.
Thanks, guys, for being on stream.
Thank you.
Faku.
See ya. Love you. Bye.
That was three rogue games in a row.
You know.
Hello.
What's up, bro?
Hello.
You made it. You did it the hard way, but you made it.
Well, we wanted to give the people a good show.
That's right. Yeah.
That's the only reason we let the stunner live.
Yes. Okay.
So.
Not because I'm bad.
It was awesome to hear you guys converse back and forth and make it work. So, Lemur, with the
high tier communication.
Yes, exactly. And your constant quest to find Krabatoa was not granted in the last two games.
One day there's going to be a Krabatoa.
Did they have Krab? They didn't, right? Saka, you saw their hand.
They got Krabatoa when it didn't really matter. So it was like on the turn 9 or something like that. They were hoping
I was utterly wrong about everything in their hand, right? Making sure.
I wouldn't say wrong. It's just the cards. Yatsir was doing you guys a favor, but Yatsir was doing you guys favors by calling out the cards that you're going to play, and on cue, like Krabatoa came down, and then he said, "Oh, look, they got a concoction, so it's probably going to be a double draw." That came up.
That's what I was doing. I said he was right.
So Corrodin was telling him to stop, giving you guys some good RNG. So
thank you, Yakshtar.
Yep,
appreciate it very much.
So any highlights besides doing the reverse sweep here? That's the obvious one.
Well, the main highlight is the lack of Krabatoa.
Right.
Yeah.
And the amazing invincible Steno that just could not be killed somehow.
You guys, they're never going to let me live it down either.
No. 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 It's a good series, though.
Yeah.
I'm glad. It's always fun when it goes to 5 games.
Our viewers like it as well. I'm sure it's pretty stressful for the players.
Yes, it is.
Experiences of the trio series real quick from each of you. How are you guys experiencing? Like, what's your experience so far? Good, bad? I know it's 2-1 now for your season.
Yes, it has been great. This is our second... Oh, man. All right, anyway, this is our second reverse sweep.
Okay.
Yeah.
And both times, it's been Gimme Lamp's fault. Because
that we've been victorious.
That we've been victorious. That should clarify. Because he wasn't here for the first two games of the last series. And this series, he called it. So we'll give him credit for that.
You going to take all that credit there, Gimme Lamp?
Of course.
Okay. Just checking.
It's been a really good time so far, though. The trios format should be here to stay. I hope.
Yeah, and from a content side of things, I think it's a little bit of a change from what we see on, you know, on Twitch and whatever for the Masters Tour and all that other stuff. So people always enjoy people having fun as well as listening to strategy of sorts. So I don't know if you guys have tuned in to other trio shows before, so
I have.
Cool.
I have. It's entertaining. It's definitely a lot better than the kind of just one person going over their plays, or people that are not playing the game talking about it. It's good, but it's a very good change of pace, I think.
Yeah.
I went back and watched the VOD for our last one, which is where I discovered that my voice was on stream, and I had a few regrets on some of the stuff I said.
Well, that's the thing. It's okay. You get wrapped up in the moment, so it's okay. It's fine. It's all good.
This time
you missed out on some good stuff. That's all I'm gonna say.
Missed on some good content. There you go.
Yes. As soon as you leave, okay, that's where it gets real.
Gets spicy. There you go. All right. Any final words before we let you guys go? So.
No.
Okay. Hope we can win again next week.
There you go. And,
this time, hopefully not in 5 games. I don't know if my heart can take it.
Perfect. All right. Well, thanks again for being on stream. I thank Corrodin and Yatsir for being on stream as well. So, but yeah,
thank you.
Enjoy your night. You got it. Take care. All right. That pretty much concludes our Friday night story. So. Looks like there's another game between Sussy Union and Triple Bros Bash, but we didn't get permissions there from them because I didn't know that they were playing at this time, but that's fine. So there are other trios matches going on, obviously with the THL in full swing with the season. There's all kinds of Legacy. There's Hero Series. There is your Pro Series as well as Wild Series. So anybody that's interested in playing in the THL, our new season is probably going to get wrapped up here in the next 5 to 7 weeks, just depending on the playoffs. But just hit us up on THLHearthLeague.com. Check out some of the information that's on there. Also, you can check out our Discord. Join Discord. Very friendly atmosphere. Very friendly grouping. But yeah, check us out. I want to thank both teams allowing us to stream their match tonight and listen in on their strategies. So, and I want to thank all the viewers that took some time to allow me to solo cast today. So, sorry for Chewy not showing up, but considering the time differences, can't blame him. So, again, Saturday night, I believe there's going to be, just double checking what's going on here in our chat. So there's a 7 p.m. I think it's, yeah, 7 p.m. Eastern match for between Leo C and Skirt Reynolds. I'm not sure if that's Legacy or Hero, but that's going to be on tomorrow night. Also have 8 p.m. Eastern. We have Classy Thug versus Nice King. So not sure if that is Legacy or Hero as well. It could be even Pro for that matter, because Classy Thug is and Nice King are very skilled players, like pretty much every other THL player in the group. But yeah, Sunday night, don't think there's going to be a stream on Sunday night just because it is Mother's Day. But if something comes up, please keep your eyeballs on the THL Discord, yeah, so through the content announcement. So, again, I want to thank everybody for joining us. I'm Saku, and we will see you very soon. Have a great weekend, everybody.